Welcome back to the e-learning on Business Analysis Body of Knowledge, BABOK version 3.0. We are discussing the third knowledge area, which is Requirements Lifecycle Management. And in that, we are going to discuss the third task, which is Prioritize Requirements. So far, we saw a task on tracing requirements, and then we saw a task on maintaining requirements, and the third one is to prioritize requirements. So why should we prioritize requirements? What's the reason? If you understand, the stakeholder requirements are many, and there isn't any way any project can meet all the requirements all the stakeholders put. And obviously, it probably doesn't make sense also to do all requirements in the beginning, because some requirements have higher value and some requirements may have lower value. So we must prioritize our requirements so that we know in what order we are going to implement these requirements. And this is what it says. So no project has unlimited budget and time, and prioritization helps us to focus on aspects which require priority implementation. And what do we do as part of this task? It is to rank requirements in order of relative importance. So that means requirements which appear on the top of the list are higher priority requirements than the requirements that appear in the bottom part of the list. So what are the elements that we need to think about? The first thing we need to think about is basis for prioritization. That means on what basis we prioritize requirements. Two, what are the challenges that we face in prioritization? And third thing is, how do we ensure continual prioritization? So let's look at each one of them. If you see the basis of prioritization, there are quite a few bases, and we will talk about each one. It could be benefit, it could be penalty, it could be cost, it could be time sensitivity, it could be dependencies, it could be risk, it could be stability, or it could be compliance. So the first basis is benefit, which means requirements those have higher benefit are prioritized on higher priority. Then penalty, that means there could be requirements, unless you implement them, you will be penalized. So obviously you must satisfy them in the higher order. Then cost, which means there could be requirements which require a lot of cost to implement. So obviously, if you don't have that kind of money in hand, you may push them to the back of the log, because you don't want to implement high cost requirements and miss out on many low cost requirements. Then risk. This is also something a lot of people say, a requirement which is risky should be implemented first, because if in case we go wrong, we have time to recover it or do something about it. Then dependencies. This is again something which we have to keep it in mind. Certain requirements must be implemented prior hand so that other requirements can be implemented. Then time sensitivity. There could be a situation when there is a new game coming up and you as a gaming company must have the game ready before the gaming season begins. And in that case, you have to make sure that you do things on time priority. Then stability. This is an interesting aspect where what one should do is requirements, those which are unstable, they can always wait because they are still not stable. And you pick up requirements which are stable for implementation. And last one is regulatory or policy compliance, which is essentially there could be a government mandate to do something, and this is something that you cannot overlook. The next element that we need to worry is challenges of prioritization. Understand that stakeholders may have different priorities. Each stakeholder is coming with a background or a need which is different from another. So for example, a product owner may like to push a feature to the market to gain market benefit, whereas the development manager may not like to do so, because the development manager may feel it's better to wait before we go to the market. So that is what you have to remember, and we must make sure that we prioritize requirements, we challenge or we observe the conflicts that exist, and then we prioritize them appropriately. Then the third element is continual prioritization, which it means that typically in the beginning we may have done a prioritization in a particular way, and that can change once we go ahead in the project. We could look at a more granular basis such as technical constraint and cost as we move forward. And please remember, a bad prioritization will obviously result in stakeholder dissatisfaction. Thank you for undergoing the module on requirements prioritization, and we hope you are able to follow the discussions, and at the same time, you are also going through the quizzes and assignments provided to you so that your learning process is completed by the time you complete the video learning module. Thank you.